Crew, welcome back to another Spercaso tutorial. So I have a short tutorial to do today. I've noticed that there's been a lot of people asking different ways of creating mountains. I do have several tutorials on that online, but I tell you what, we can make one real quick. Okay, this is the poster board that you can get on my website. This is the poster board that I use for creating all my spray paintings. Let's put that down. This is an 11 by 14. Again, we're gonna use the soft tip tool, and let's begin. All right, so let's see. To create a mountain, there are several ways. The first way I'm going to show you is you create the background first. And to create the background, I'm going to use some pretty bright colors, maybe some pink. Make sure you shake before every use, because you want the drying chemical and the gloss chemical to mix with the paint. Have you ever done it where you start spray painting and nothing, if you don't shake your can, you have nothing but the clear that comes out, maybe with a little bit of color? You don't want that. You want that to be mixed in with the paint. So when you spray, you get the nice color. Otherwise, see, I haven't shaken this can yet, so I'll show you. See, and then it comes out really, really strong on the color, but at first it's very light. Yeah, you want to try and prevent that. So you want to make sure you shake your cans very well before every use. Clogged up. Now I'm having a little bit of trouble with this can. It's got a little bit of paint inside of it, and I don't have a needle. Usually what you do is you poke the hole and it clears out the whatever it is that is clogging it up. But I mean, for today's tutorial, this is gonna be just fine. I'm gonna use a little bit of our purple. Guys, once again, thank you. I keep getting emails about this. I no longer have any more of the Spercaso paints. I was only able to get 25 batches of it. Those have sold online already. But I will order more. I will. Let me see if I can fix this. Anyways, all right. I'm just gonna get a little more pink here. Now, what I'm doing here is I'm creating the background. Look at that, making it look like clouds, huh? It's pretty good. All right. All right, so I went ahead and I created the background. And that was just using a little bit of pink. Now, I'm not sure what's going on with the cap here, but I'm having a lot of splatter down here. That usually doesn't happen. I'm not sure what it is. So, but thankfully, I still have one of my Spercaso test paints. So, I don't have to worry about that splatter down there. Alright, so here I'm just creating a nice little fluorescent-like background. Now, notice how I created these clouds. Hopefully, this will tackle a few more questions that I've had, too, on how to create clouds. This is just one technique, guys, where I added a darker color. In this case, it was purple. Then with a pink, I just hit the bottom part of them. This will allow you to create the illusion that there's sunlight coming in from somewhere down here and lighting it up the clouds a little bit on top. The next step we're gonna do is we're gonna grab a magazine sheet. Something like this. Now this is one of those magazines that you get for free. You ever go to a store somewhere and they have those outside, either at the entrance or as you're leaving the store. See, this magazine, I've already used it completely. I'm just going to toss this one. Use the new one. So what I do is I just put the magazine on the side and I paint or start tearing pieces off the first page. And as I use it, you know, I keep using the pages underneath. All right, so I'm just gonna put my tools here. I use a little bit of black. Now it's important that when, notice how I picked up the can and a lot of trash landed on our painting. So guys, when doing this, make sure you try and clean your cans outside your painting area. This is a mistake I've done before, and those things can be a little bit annoying to remove. You can use your tool. Help you remove them. And it's always, I always recommend, guys, that you get paper towels. Get a paper towel that you can just keep handy. Be able to clean your tool, right? Okay, I'm gonna use a little bit of black here. Soft tip tool. It's gonna tap. I'm gonna create the outline of the mountain. You know what, guys? There's really nothing that says, "Oh, your mountain has to look like this. It has to look like that." No, you just use your imagination. Whatever you think. I mean, you can use a picture of a real mountain if you want to make a mountain that exists near your location, an actual mountain. You could do that. In this case, I'm just making one up. I need to clear out my space here so I can move my tool. Look at that. A little bit of pressure and you can create your own highlights. Though I don't recommend you make too much of the highlights where it shows the negative space on your poster, on your canvas, but just enough to where you can see the lighter areas. See that? Now there's different ways of creating mountains. This is just one of them, and I think this is probably one of the faster ones. Pretty easy, right? I mean, look how fast we were able to create a mountain. Now, one thing you can do, just to add depth to this mountain, so I recommend you get a little bit of white. Let me spray paint this up on the side until the white comes out. Notice how the white came out. It took, I don't know, half a second. You have to make sure you spray it and make sure that the white comes out. Once the color comes out, you can add a little bit of white here just to make the effect that there's a cloud here on the bottom. And so then you have your mountain that kind of comes out like that. And you just fade that out. Pretty cool, huh? Okay. Do that. You know what? You can use a little bit of a sea sponge. Like this. Tap, tap, tap. And actually, I think this might be too much. You just need a little bit of it. Just, you don't need a whole lot of it. You can come in here and you can just kind of create a little landscape off in the distance. Have to add a whole lot of detail. And see, what we're doing here is we're adding the black, yes, but it's actually mixing with some of the colors that we had below as well. You kind of want that because it'll give you the same color scheme that you have on your mountain up above. A little bit of clear coat. I'm just going to tap here just a little bit. A little bit more. And here on this bottom part, I'm just going to smear it together. And look how fast and how easy you were able to create a mountain, a little bit of water underneath, And then you can start kind of bringing it home. You know, you can start adding layers that make it closer to us and give the perception that the mountain is really far and is, you know, really huge too. How do you do that? Well, just add a little bit of black. And kind of mix the same colors that we have underneath with the black. This way. And create a terrain that's really close to us. Very easy, very fast. You can add some trees that come out, perhaps another piece of terrain right here. It is a little bit closer to us, but you can still see some of the water underneath. And there you have it. Very easy, very fast, and you can do this live. Than having to worry about not having enough time to create or spending too much time on a piece of work. All right, crew. Well, I hope this has helped you guys with a lot of the questions that you've had. I hope to hear you soon. Or hear your comments. See you guys soon. All right, crew. Until next time, keep those cans shaking.